Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by John Black. He's the CEO of Regulus Resources. John, very good to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Stephen.
So John, for those viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us more about Regulus Resources?
Yeah, actually, at Regulus, we're a group of seasoned explorations with a lot of years of experience in South America. And the style of junior company that we operate is that we try to identify projects that have potential to be very large copper or copper gold deposits, acquire those when there's a downturn in the market or an opportunity to acquire those inexpensively. And then we drill those out, we de-risk those, and then ideally we sell them to a major mining company as our strategy. Regulus is actually the second of three companies that we've had in our management team. Our first company, Antares Minerals, we successfully discovered a very interesting porphyry in southern Peru that we sold to First Quantum. With Regulus, we have the AntaKori copper gold project in northern Peru, which we think we're well on the pathway to a similar story. And we have a third company called Aldebaran that has a very interesting copper gold project in Argentina. But today we'll focus on Regulus and the AntaKori project.
Well, tell us more about AntaKori then and what it is that excites you about this project.
AntaKori is actually a rather unusual opportunity. It's a very large copper gold system. Geologically, it contains both skarn style mineralization and high sulfidation epithermal mineralization, both of which have very significant copper gold contents too. And we actually have half of the overall project. The neighbors next door to us have an operating mine that's mining the oxide cap, essentially pre-stripping the deposit and exposing the sulfides on their side. And then we have the other half of the deposit on our side of the line. So it's a very large copper gold sulfide that's effectively in a brownfield setting with an existing oxide gold mine that is soon to run out of ore. And there's a logical district consolidation and transition into a much larger long-lived copper gold opportunity. And we think we have a key piece of that.
How advanced are you with the project? I understand you're busy completing phase two drilling at the mine.
We're still at the resource definition stage. We've announced our first resource. We have a little over 500 million tons of combined mineralization, about half of that indicated, half of that inferred. And that's at a copper equivalent grade of about 0.7% copper, so relatively high grade and very low strip ratio. And as I mentioned, that's really only a portion of the overall deposit. We have a portion on our side, the neighbors have a portion on their side, and on both sides, there's potential to continue to grow the overall deposit size.
And of course, an exciting time to be in copper with the clean energy transition, John.
It's an absolutely exciting time, but a rather challenging market. So I think there's a general consensus and recognition that copper will be fundamental for us as we go into an energy transition and try to use less carbon overall. That requires more electricity, and copper runs electricity, basically. So it's a great time to have our hands on an exciting copper asset like this. It doesn't hurt that it has some good precious metals content to it as well. But the markets are presenting a few challenges, and that's where experience as a company that's been through a few downturns like this plays out for us.
I mean, despite those challenges, you've recently announced a $5 million investment from Osisko. It's a royalty-linked deal. Tell us about that, because that is a vote of confidence, isn't it?
It is a vote of confidence. Osisko Gold Royalties are already partners. They do hold some royalties in the district with us. They've provided funding for us to move forward. But as I mentioned, in challenging times like this, one, it's difficult for a group like us to raise money in a traditional private placement. It's also not very attractive for us to do it because it's at lower prices. It's highly dilutive to our existing shareholders. And so when we encounter times like this, what we try to do is seek out opportunities that protect our shareholders' value as much as we can, but still provide us with the funds that we need to move the project forward. So this was an outstanding opportunity for us to work with an existing partner with Osisko Gold Royalties, a strong endorsement of the project. And most importantly, it keeps our share count down.
Tell us how the royalty arrangement will work, John.
What Osisko Gold Royalties already owns some royalties in the core part of the district in a transaction that we did a couple of years ago. This provides them some additional royalties and peripheral properties on the ground. So these would be properties that are quite far out in the mine life, but with existing mineralization and quite potentially more mineralization. So good bet for Osisko in the long run. but it doesn't really affect the project too much in the short run. So it's a great balance between providing us with that cash to come in. They pay us $5 million US. There's no shares issued within that. We can use that money to advance the project. And from the Osisko Gold Royalties viewpoint, it's important that we are advancing the project as quickly as possible because their royalty company, and they begin to see those royalties on production. So that when you see a royalty company come into an opportunity like this, it's a vote of confidence on the project and a vote of confidence that it will become a mine in relatively short order.
John, what are some of the catalysts that investors should be looking out for in the short to medium term?
We're currently drilling with two rigs. We're approaching the conclusion of our phase two program. Phase one produced the resource that I mentioned that we put out in 2019. We've almost doubled the amount of drilling that we've drilled since that point in time. With the phase two program completed approximately at the end of the year, we'll be in a position to update the resource in about Q2 of 2023 next year. Another important milestone to watch right now is we've built our land position to the north of the existing mine by acquiring 100% claims of our own, but also a couple of agreements that allow us to earn into properties that were held by major companies. One of those is the Kokirumi joint venture, where we can earn into a large block of ground that consolidates our land position from a subsidiary of Buenaventura on the north side. We're just completing the required drilling to earn into a 70% interest in that ground. So we'll be announcing that to our partners, at which time they have a decision to allow us to have the 70% interest in that ground, or they can claw back to 70%, leaving us with 30 by paying us US $9 million. And that discussion and decision will be made by approximately January. They have a time frame to determine if they'd like to do that. So that's potentially a financing for us to go forward, or that we earn 70% of an important block of ground. Both outcomes are great news for us.
That sounds like it. And John, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thank you very much for the introduction today.
Great. Thank you very much, and look forward to talking with you in the future.
John Black is CEO of Regulus Resources.